Of the Lord, you are welcome to our Open Doors Sunday. Be expectant, because God first opens the doors in the realm of the spirit before it manifests in the physical. And so God is going to open major doors for you in the name of Jesus. Are you ready for the word? All right, turn with me, please, in your Bibles to the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 33. Matthew, chapter 6, verse 33. Jesus said, "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." And we are blessed by the reading of God's word. Let's read it together. Ready, go. Matthew 6, 33. Jesus said, "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." And we are blessed by the reading of God's word. I'm continuing concluding my series that I have titled, How to Access Divine Favor. How to Access Divine Favor. And this is part four. It is easy to access divine favor in the kingdom of God. And how to access it is simply loving and doing what God loves. Loving and doing what God loves. How many of you here, you work. You don't work for yourself, but you work somewhere. You all work somewhere. Now, wherever you are working, when you were first employed, you were given terms and conditions of your employment. And in the terms and conditions of your employment, there are do's and don'ts in the terms and conditions of your employment. There are do's and don'ts. And if you want to be promoted or you want to progress in the company, you do the do's. Isn't that right? You do the do's. And if you want to be sacked, you do the don'ts. Is that right? If you want to be sacked, if they say don't do something, you do it, you'll be sacked. You get a suspension, or you get disciplinary procedures, maybe oral warning, then written warning, first written warning, second written warning, and then maybe final written warning, and then you are gone. And so you have to do the do. You have to do the do's of that organization to be promoted. The same is true in the kingdom of God. If you want to access divine favor from God, you have to do what God loves. Amen? You have to do what? The things that God loves. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 2 verse 52 that Jesus increased in stature, he increased in wisdom, he increased in stature, he increased in favor with God and favor with man. Favor with God and favor with man. And so if you want to access divine favor in the kingdom, you must love what God loves. You must love what God loves. And what does God love? Souls. What does God love? Souls. That's why John 3:16, it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have what? Everlasting life." So God loves souls. That's why he gave his only begotten Son to die for souls. And so as a church, we must also love souls. If we are going to access divine favor, we must love what God loves. Write this down. Until what is important to God becomes important to you, what is important to you will never be important to God. Please write that down. Until what is important to God becomes important to you, what is important to you will never be important to God. Do you have some important things that you want them to be important to God? Yeah. Be interested in the things that are important to God. And that is souls. And so when we call for soul winning, you must be there because it's important to God. When you are out and about, be interested in winning souls to Jesus. When we call for prayer for souls, be interested in it and be part of it. Be there. Be there. If you are not there, it means you are not interested. You are not interested in the things that concerns God. And if the things that concerns God doesn't concern you, whatever concerns you will not be concerned about God. That's the simplest way of being elevated in this kingdom. Just love what God loves. Just do what? Love what God loves. Just love God. What God loves. Just love what God loves. Look at Hebrews chapter 1 verse 8 and 9. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 8 and 9. Listen carefully. It says, but to the Son, he says, your throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is a scepter of your kingdom. Now look, verse 9. It says, you have loved righteousness and hated lawlessness. So look, every time you love what God loves, look at the outcome. It says, therefore God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions. Hallelujah. And so every time you love what God loves, he promotes you. He promotes you. It says you have loved righteousness. Why? Because God loves righteousness. And hated lawlessness. God hates lawlessness. Isn't that right? It says because you are loving what God loves, on the basis of that, it says, therefore your God has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions. Don't worry about what others are doing. Just love what God loves. Just love what God loves. I want to show you one person in scripture who didn't love what God loves, and look at what happened to him. He was interested in things. Like I've said, many of the times we go chasing things. We chase things so much we forget who God is. And most of the time, even in our coming to church, we are not coming to church because we really love God. We are coming to church because we want things. We want things from God. Praise the Lord. We want things from God. We want something from God. So God, I'll come to church and pray and serve you. Once I get the things, that's it. I'm gone. Why? And so look at somebody who went chasing things and look at the outcome. He wasn't chasing God. 2 Kings chapter 5 from verse 20 to 27. 2 Kings chapter 5 from verse 20 to 27. This is a story about Naaman. How many of you remember Naaman? Naaman was a general who had leprosy. He was a great general. He had leprosy. And then his king sent a letter to the king of Israel for Elisha to cure him of his leprosy. And so when Naaman came to Elisha, Elisha said to him, go and dip yourself in the Jordan 7 times. And then Naaman reacted to that instruction. He said, wow, how can he tell me to go and dip myself in the Jordan? Does he not know that even the waters of Paha and so on and so forth are nicer? I have better swimming pools in my house. Why is he asking me to go and dip myself in this dirty, smelly Jordan? And then the servant of Naaman said to him, I mean, master, if this man says you should do it, just go and do it. And thank God, he went, he digged himself 7 times, and his flesh became that of a baby. Leprosy was cleansed, and he became that of a baby. Now, because the leprosy was cleansed, this is what happens. The Bible says he gave Elisha some presents. And as a man of God, it's not every time you pray for people and they are healed, and then they give you a present, you take it. You don't take. Once you take it, you are telling them you are the healer. You don't take. And so Elisha rejected the gifts. But Elisha had a servant called Gehazi. And I want to show you what Gehazi did. Gehazi doesn't love God. Gehazi loves things. He loves things. He's a lover of things. That's why nothing in the hands of Gehazi ever worked. When Elisha even gave Gehazi his mantle to go and put on the woman's child, the mantle didn't work. This is the same mantle that worked in the hands of Elijah. It worked in the hands of Elisha, but it didn't work in the hands of Gehazi. Why? Because his heart was not right. His heart was, there are too many Gehazis in the church today. I pray that you are not a Gehazi. So 2 Kings chapter 5 verse 20 to 27. I read, the Bible says, after Elisha asked Naaman to take the things, look at what Gehazi did. He said, but Gehazi, the servant of Elisha, the man of God, said, look, my master has spared Naaman, this Syrian. My master has spared him. Look at his mindset. Then my master has spared, because he was expecting his master to take the goodies. He said, my master has spared this Naaman the Syrian while not receiving from his hands what he brought. But as the Lord lives, I'll run after him and take something from him. You see, sometimes we do the wrong things in the name of the Lord. Look at what he's doing, the wrong thing. And then he said, as the Lord lives, which Lord? This is not God. So sometimes people can do things in the name of God, but it's wrong. He said, as the Lord lives, I'll run after him and take something from him. Somebody say, take something from him. Stop going after things. Go after God. 2024, you must go after God. So Gehazi pursued Naaman. Look, I wish he uses that strength to pursue God. So Gehazi pursued Naaman. Praise God. Praise the Lord. So Gehazi pursued Naaman. I pray for you that this year you pursue God. Don't pursue people. Don't pursue human beings. Don't pursue things. Pursue God. Don't pursue money. Pursue God. Don't pursue miracles. Pursue God. Pursue the miracle worker. So Gehazi pursued Naaman. When Naaman saw him running after him, I wish we ran after God like this. He got down from the chariot to meet him and said, is all well? And he said, all is well. Liar. He knows the church lingo. Are you well? All is well. It is well. I am blessed and highly favored. Praise the Lord, Pastor. Praise the Lord, Sister. He knows the church lingo. He knows the church lingo. He has the lingos of the church. He comes to church. He records all the lingos. All the lingos. He knows what lingo to use when somebody says something. Are you all right, sister? Oh, praise the Lord. I am highly favored. I am blessed on my right. I am blessed on my left. I'm blessed behind. I'm blessed in front. My going in and my coming out is blessed. I'm walking in open doors. He has all the lingos. All the lingos. All the lingos he has. He said, all is well, but he knows all is not well. Then look, he went further. He said, my master has sent me saying, did the master send him? No. So there are many people in the church lying in the name of God. Lying in the name of the church. Lying in the name of the pastor. My master has sent me. Where were you sent?
We've sent you to go and win souls, not to go and do anything. That's the only thing we have sent you to go and do. Praise God. The only thing we have sent you to go and do is to win souls. That's all. That's all. It's not difficult. Win souls. Invite someone. Do you have parties? Do you have parties? Do you invite somebody to your parties? Yeah. That's all we're asking you to do. Invite somebody to the house of God. But look again, as he said, all is well. My master has sent me, say, indeed, just now, two men of the sons of the prophets have come to me from the mountains of Ephraim. Where did he concoct all these lies from? Just now, two men of the sons of the prophet has come from the mountain of Ephraim. Please give them a talent of silver and two changes of garment. Gehazi. Lying to get things. Gehazi in the church, a man, single man, want to get married to a sister, lying to get into the sister's business. Lying, Gehazis. We must be careful of Gehazis this year. Hallelujah. So Naaman said, verse 23, please take two talents. And he urged him and bound two talents of silver in two bags with two changes of garments and handed him to two of his servants, and they carried them on ahead of him. Look at Gehazi. He's even got people carrying the curse for him. Carrying lies. They are carrying. They've gone ahead of him. And Gehazi is following them like a big man. Today is my day. Today is my day of testimony. This is Sunday. Open doors. Pastor doesn't know. Next week when I come, when he sees the garments, when he sees the silver, he'll know that I have really entered into open door. Don't you know even Satan can open doors? Yeah. Satan can also open doors. It's not every door that is open that you know is of God. You must have the spirit of discernment to know that this one is of God, this one is not of God. They were going, and Gehazi was walking majestically. Majestically, Gehazi. Whoo! The Gehazi said, I have blown. The man don't blow. Yeah, he's feeling good. But we have to be careful. Next verse 24. The Bible says, when he came to the citadel, the pinnacle, does that remind you of Satan, where he took Jesus to? He took them from their hand and stored them away in the house. Then he let the men go and they departed. He stored them away. We are doing building funds. Some of you have stored away your silver. Stored away, hidden away. Say, God, this one, I'm preparing this money for something. Don't let God blow it away. Don't be a Gehazi. The church is quiet all of a sudden. You were laughing 1 minute ago. Now, when the word start getting into your business, you go, You stop laughing. You stop responding. Don't hide your money away from God. Remember, God owns that money. Amen. 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 Give it to God. Amen. Invest in the house of God. Don't be asked to invest. Just know the Holy Spirit. Some of you, the Holy Spirit has already spoken to you, told you that Isaac money there is for the church building. It's for the church building. And so, Pastor, you don't know. God, you don't know. You don't know how I've struggled. The same God who gave you will give you more. So don't be a Gehazi. Don't hide it away in the house. Verse 25, the Bible says that now, when he went in and stood before his master, please remember, we'll all stand before our master. His name is Jesus. One day we'll stand before him. Now you are hiding corner, but one day, somebody say one day. Somebody say one day. We will all stand before the master. Now he went in and stood before his master. Elisha said to him, where did you go, Gehazi? And he said, your servant did not go anywhere. You see, it's from one lie to another lie. You see, when you lie once, you have to find another lie to cover that lie, and find another lie to cover that lie, and find another lie, and keep covering lie upon lie. Then he said, then Elisha said to him, many of us don't know that God is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. Then Elisha said to him, did not my heart go with you when the man turned back from his chariots to meet you? Don't think you are playing games with God. He said, my heart, in other words, my spirit went with you. It went with you. It went with you when you are running after the man and say, stop the chariots. Two sons of prophets have come. My spirit was with you. And then he said, is it time to receive money and to receive clothing, olive groves and vineyard, sheep and oxen, male and female servants? That means there's time for everything. This is not the time. This is not the time. This is the time to seek God. Don't seek things. Jesus says, seek first the kingdom of God. Don't seek things. Don't run after things. Yes, we know you are looking for a visa. We know you are believing God for a house. We know you want to get married this year. We know you are believing God for the fruit of the womb. But don't seek after them. Go after God. Let your heart go after God. Love what God loves. Pursue God with all your heart. Pursue God with all your heart. Amen. He said, my heart went with you. My spirit went with you. When you were in your house doing those secret things, I could see everything. I could see everything. Have you not been to church before and I'm preaching and I say things and you wonder, who told Pastor about my business? Yeah, my spirit is with you. Nobody told me your business. The Holy Spirit is telling me to tell you to stop it. Somebody say, stop it. Look at somebody and tell them, stop it. Stop it. Did you tell them? As that thought is coming through your mind, stop it right there. Verse 27, the Bible says that because of what happened, then the leprosy of Naaman shall come and cling unto you and your descendants forever. And he went out from his presence, leprous as white as snow. How sad. How sad. How sad. This is very sad. This is very sad. Gehazi would have carried a double portion or a quadruple portion of Elisha's anointing.
But look, he's going after things. The leprosy that left Naaman. Left Naaman. Naaman is sorted. He is going back to Syria. A free healed man. That leprosy that has left and gone into the Jordan has clinged onto Gehazi. That's why I say that when you chase things, you lose the things and you lose God. He lost everything. He lost everything he got. He lost everything. This year, don't chase things. Amen. God knows you need the thing. Listen, yeah. God is not dumb. Excuse my language. God is not a fool. Yeah. God knows you need it. God knows. God knows what you need better than you yourself know what you need. God knows what you need better than you know what you need. But don't go after the things. Go after God. Amen. When you go after God, the things will come. Amen. The things will come. And more. The things will come. And more. That's why when we tell you go and win souls, you say, this is basic. Why don't they show me how to prosper? Their prosperity is in the winning of the souls. Their prosperity is in the souls. The Bible says that, and Gehazi became leprous. The leprosy from Naaman, I pray for you, that the leprosy from the world will not cling on you. Listen, God is real. Don't be in the church and play games with God. Can I say that again? Don't be in the church and play games with God. Because God is real. God is real. I said God is real. God is real. I said God is real. And so don't play games with God. Don't play games with God. God knows what you need. He can take care of you. But first seek first the kingdom of God. You want to access, you see, some of us this year, we are not going to chase favor. Favor will chase.